Hello everyone, welcome back to Act of Learning. A cycloid is a curve traced by a point on the circumference of a circle rolling on a straight line. This curve has the remarkable property of being the curve of fastest descent under a constant gravitational field, much faster than a straight line, showing that the shortest path doesn't necessarily mean shortest time. Even more amazing is the fact that the cycloid is also a tautochrone curve, the curve for which the time taken by an object sliding without friction in uniform gravity to its lowest point is independent of its starting position. But this only works on a plane surface. What about a bead sliding along the surface of a sphere? Do we have a tautochrone curve? If yes, does it have a closed form solution and how do we find such a curve? Even though this looks like an impossible task to solve, we don't have to look any further than the simplest of mechanical models, the simple pendulum, to solve this. Galileo observed that the simple pendulum is also isochronous. The time period of oscillation is independent of the initial angle of the pendulum. The period that we have here is the time taken for the pendulum to reach its lowest point from the starting point, or the other way around. But it is now well understood that the pendulum maintained its isochronous property only at small angles, but that is not a deterrent for our analysis. The potential energy of the pendulum, which is the key to our solution, can be expressed in terms of the angle theta. But because we are interested only in the case of small angles, we use a small angle approximation of the cosine term and slightly rearrange the resulting expression. Rather than using the parameter theta, which is specific to the case of a simple pendulum, we use the arc length as the main parameter. Eliminating the g by l term using the expression for the time period, we finally see that the potential energy of an object sliding along the tautochronous curve must be directly proportional to the square of the arc length of the curve. But for an arbitrary curve, this potential energy comes from the height from which the sliding particle is located at any given instant. Equating the two, we finally get the condition to be satisfied by any tautochronous curve. But having an explicit expression for arc length makes this little tricky to use. So we differentiate this equation and choose the negative sign to be consistent with the fact that the arc length to be traversed reduces as we get closer to the lowest point of the curve. This is the key equation that enables us to solve for a tautochronous curve in any coordinate system. We'll now use this to find the tautochrone on a spherical surface. Just like the Cartesian coordinate system, we need three values to specify the location of a particle in a spherical coordinate system. Because the particle is always going to be on the surface of a sphere, that leaves us with two coordinates. The polar angle theta, which measures the angle between the radial line and the z-axis, and the azimuthal angle phi, which measures the angle between the x-axis and the radial line's projection on the xy plane. Keeping phi constant and varying theta gives us the green circle with radius equal to that of the sphere, while keeping theta constant and varying phi gives us the red circle with the radius sine theta. Now back to the main problem. If we assume that the plane tangent to the sphere at the south pole is the base for potential energy, then the potential energy of the particle is proportional to 1 plus cos theta, assuming an unit sphere. Likewise, the square of the infinitesimal arc length can be found by considering small variations in theta and phi and applying the Pythagorean theorem. Now that we have this, the rest is just simple substitutions. But before we get to that, we just rephrase the time period in terms of a parameter lambda. This is just a cosmetic change that we do to make the final expression that we are about to get a little more nicer. Substituting all this, we get a differential equation between phi and theta of the tautochrone's curve. This may look hard, but surprisingly can be solved in closed form. And yes, there we have it, the cycloid's counterpart on a spherical surface where the time taken by a particle sliding along this curve to reach the south pole is independent of its starting position. Amazingly, this curve also has another very nice property that we will cover in a later video. Hope you enjoyed the discussion. Thanks for joining me and see you in the next video.